And we're gonna go ahead and do our lower lash line with the mascara as well. And it just helps pull that that bright green color that we put, kind of just helped, you know, pull it, tone it down a notch so that it wouldn't just bow bright green. This is what we have so far as far as eyeshadow is concerned. I'm gonna go ahead and do my face, and I'm gonna show you kind of just a little everyday look. Sometimes I'll feel like wearing foundation, so I'm gonna go ahead and have a concealer palette, and use darker colors, and I'm gonna go ahead and do it right underneath my eyes. Also, is I just take it and just kind of spot it on my face like it's foundation. But this concealer is really, really thin, so it's really smooth. It feels lighter to me than foundation. I don't feel like my foundation's dead. So I just kind of spot it on. Cheeks, I do this part of my cheeks because that's the darkest part for me. I have hyperpigmentation on there and stash. It's really not a stash, so it's just dark, so. This is the most special I've ever seen. So I just kind of go around that. So I have to tease me about having a stash. Then we take our MW50 Studio Fix Powder. This is one of my favorite powders. I don't use this. I use the Select SPF 15 foundation, or I use the Revlon Colorstay foundation. I think for this new look. So we have a smooth bone. And so now it's time to put on the bronze cream color base. Put it right here on the highlight part of your cheeks, go up to your temple. You can either blend it out with your finger, or you can take your trusty one. So you're going to buff that in. Trusty bestie, if you don't have a sun brush, you might get one. You can both apply the foundation with the Miss Pink, but really, because of the